would you teach those parts, and then everything is in a sit, because you wind up with this one-dimensional dog that, you know, what they do is sit. But now you've got nose bob, you've got mats, you have so many different things that you can kind of do and just have fun with her. And you will start to read your dog's face. I mean, she's got such a lovely face, you know. Such a lovely face. And be sure to do the nose bob on the other hand, too.
Okay.
Hey!
Try it on the other hand. Can you try it on the other hand?
Yeah, let's try it on the other hand.
There she is, good girl. Good girl.
That's just lovely.
Oh, good girl.
Did you teach her this before? I showed it to you.
No, but there she is. Good job. Good job.
Oh, my God.
Good girl. That's a good girl. That's a good girl. That's a good girl. Hey, look at me. No, look at me. Good girl. Good girl. I don't have anything.
All done.
All done.
And then just ignore. So,
off.
One of the things with the mat that you're good when you're training, and they start to, well, they go right back. Pushing them away, right back. So you see, pushing away is a game for them.
Mm-hmm.
They come right back. So where you want her to be, you might push her away from that, and she'll come back and be there. It's just how their mind works. It's hey, hi, good. Yeah, let's push you this way. Yeah, good. Let's push you this way. Good. And you know, it's just, it's in their DNA. That's why when they jump up on you and you push them down, they come back and they jump up on you, because it's almost guaranteed that they're going to do that, you know?
Okay.
That's in the genes. That's a play move. So you exploit the play move somewhere else. Should we take a walk?
Yeah, take a walk.
Okay, you can get her leash on. GoPro, stop capture.
Good girl. That's a good girl.
GoPro, stop capture.